I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Insight into Chemical Engineering. In this lecture series, we will solve the unsolved problem of a famous book, Stoichiometry and Process Calculations by K.V. Narayanan. These lectures are helpful for chemical engineering students because process calculation is a core subject for chemical engineering branch. During lecture, step-by-step solution will be provided. And in this lecture, exercise number 4.9 to 4.13 will be covered. Please like and subscribe for motivation. Problem number 4.9. Calculate the density at standard temperature and pressure for methane and sulfur dioxide. We know density equal to mass per unit volume. So in order to estimate density, mass and volume should be known. So we have given standard temperature and pressure conditions. We know any gas occupies 22.4 liter of volume at STP conditions. We can take 1 mole as our basis and we can do the calculation. We can write at standard conditions 1 mole of any gas occupies 22.4 liter. Convert this liter to meter cube. We can write the molecular weight of CH4 and SO2. So this molecular weight will become the weight of CH4 and SO2 because we have started with 1 mole. Now we can estimate the density of CH4. For density, we will divide mass by volume. So mass is 16 gram. So convert this gram to kg so that the unit of density will come out as kg per meter cube. In the same way, we can estimate the density of SO2 and it will come out as 2.857 kg per meter cube. Now problem number 4.10. A 50 meter diameter spherical balloon contains air at certain temperature and pressure. How many kilogram of air is present in the balloon? So we can use ideal gas equation. For that, volume should be known. Now it is given that the balloon is spherical. So we can find out the volume of sphere and that volume will become the volume of air. So first find the volume of spherical balloon. So we can write volume of sphere equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now diameter is given, so radius will become half of diameter. So we can easily estimate the volume of sphere. So depending on the unit of radius, the unit of volume will become meter cube. Now we can use ideal gas equation. So pressure, volume, temperature are known. We can estimate the number of moles. So number of moles will come out this much. Now we need to find the weight of air. So we can estimate the weight of air because molecular weight of air is known. So weight of air will become equal to moles of air into its molecular weight. So this will come in gram. So convert this gram to kg. Problem number 4.11. Find the mass of methane in a 100 meter cube gas holder at 293 Kelvin. If the pressure on the holder is 20 kilopascal gauge, the barometric pressure is 100 kilopascal. In this case, the gauge pressure is given So first we need to estimate the absolute pressure, because the gauge pressures are calibrated to read zero in the atmosphere. So we need to estimate the absolute pressure of the methane gas, then we can use the ideal gas equation. So in this problem, the barometric pressure is also given, and barometric pressure means atmospheric pressure. Now how we will estimate the absolute pressure of methane? So for example, we have our base and we are calling it absolute vacuum. So at absolute vacuum, absolute pressure is zero, and somewhere we have our atmospheric pressure. Now the gauge pressure will give reading above the atmosphere pressure, and we need to estimate the absolute pressure. So for absolute pressure, we will start from P absolute equal to zero. So from this easily we can understand that P absolute will be equal to summation of this pressure term plus P gauge pressure. So P absolute will become equal to P gauge plus P atmosphere. Now we can write P absolute equal to 20 plus 100. So it will become equal to 120 kilopascal. Now we can use ideal gas equation, and using ideal gas equation, we can estimate the number of moles. Now weight of methane will be equal to moles of methane into its molecular weight, and it will come out as 78.82 kg. Problem number 4.12. How many kilograms of hydrogen can be stored at 325 Kelvin and 100 bar in a compressed gas cylinder that normally holds 0.5 kg hydrogen at 300 Kelvin and 130 bar? So here we have a gas cylinder that normally holds certain amount of hydrogen at 300 Kelvin and 130 bar, and we need to estimate under same volume conditions how many kilogram of hydrogen will be stored at 325 Kelvin and 100 bar. So in this problem, the volume is kept constant, so V1 equal to V2. So at initial state, so this is the initial state. At initial state, weight of hydrogen is given, temperature and pressure are given. So we can write P1 V1 equal to N1 R T1. So number of moles can be written as weight divided by molecular weight. So weight of hydrogen is 0.5 kg and molecular weight of hydrogen is 2. So we can put the all values, and we are calling it as equation 1. Now at final state, we can write P2 V2 equal to N2 R T2. So again we can put the values of P2 and T2. And N2 is written as weight divided by molecular weight. So this weight is unknown, and we are calling this equation as second. Now using equation 1 and 2, we can estimate the weight. So we will simply divide both equations. So in both equations, V1 equal to V2, it will cancel out, and we can estimate the weight. So this weight will come out as 0.355 kg. Problem number Problem number 4.13. A tank contains oxygen at certain pressure. Newton per meter square is the unit of pressure and Newton meter square equal to Pascal. On withdrawing 140 liter of oxygen measured at certain pressure, the pressure in the tank is observed to fall to certain pressure. Assume that there is no change in the temperature of the gas. What is the volume of the tank in meter cube? So in this problem, temperature is kept constant. So first we will try to understand the problem. So as per problem, it is given at the initial state, the pressure is given and volume, temperature, number of moles are not known. Now gas is withdrawn and the conditions for withdrawn gas is given. So this is the removed gas. Suppose n number of moles are removed from this container and the pressure of this removed gas and the volume of removed gas are given. So this is the final state. So at final states, we are assuming the number of moles left equal to N2. Now we are using the same container. So at initial state and final state, volume will also remain same. Now first we can do the mole balance. So initially we have started with N1 moles. Now out of N1 moles, N1 are drawn and we left with N2. So we can simply do the mole balance. So as per mole balance, N1 equal to N plus N2 and we are calling it as equation 1. Now using ideal gas equation at state 1 and 2. So this is the state 1 and this is the state 2. So at both states we can use the ideal gas equation and we will divide the ideal gas equation. So we will get P1 V1 divided by P2 V2 equal to N1 RT1 divided by N2 RT2. And we will put the known values. So from this we can estimate N1 by N2. Because RT, RT, it will get cancelled and V1 equal to V2. And the values of P1 and P2 are given. So N1 by N2 will come out as 1400 divided by 13. So further, we can write N1 equal to 107.69N2 and we are calling it as equation 2. Now again we are using the ideal gas law at state 2 and the gas removed. So this is the state 2 and this is the gas removed. So again we will divide the ideal gas equation and we can simply write the known values. So N2 by N1 will come out in term of V2. So further we can write N2 by N equal to N2 divided by N1 minus N2 using equation 1. So from this equation we can write N equal to N1 minus N2. Now further we can write N1 can be written as 107.69N2. Now in this equation the N2 will get cancelled. So simply we can write this equation equal to this much. Now we can solve it for V2. So V2 will come out as 1.0195 liter.